holidays were exciting to fly. Everybody is usually in a good mood and you can just feel it on the aircraft. For crew members, it sometimes sucks.
And the phone rang, I don't know, sometime early afternoon. Hey, Ken, we need a favor. We need somebody to fly this trip, and would you mind flying it? We'll make it up to you. And in those days, when one of the crew schedules said, we'll make it up to you, they really meant it. You know, you would get some fat cat trip that probably they would have given to somebody else.
On the 31st, this was one flight for the month that was early, and it was the first New Year's Eve I was going out in several years.
I told Marcy, I said, told her what time to put the roast in the oven, and I said, I should be back in plenty of time for dinner, and we should have been back in plenty of time for dinner.
So I was really looking forward to landing around 6 at night and having a normal New Year's Eve celebration.
At the beginning of the flight, Regina called us, me and the other flight attendant, Kathy Shea, in the back of the airplane, to tell us that we were going to have armed marshals, three armed marshals, and to not serve them any alcohol, which we didn't. I noticed that there was a fourth man with them because they were on my side of the airplane.
And I think he had on dark glasses, and you didn't see any handcuffs. I think he had something over him. But there were guys around him, and again, I didn't think anything of it.
You know, I really didn't put much thought to that at the time, but in hindsight, obviously, yes, there was definitely a gun planted for him.
And that, I don't think everyone knew all the details about where those guns came from. If each bodyguard just had two, how did he have one in his pants and two over here? There was extra guns. So how did those guns get in there? And then, you know, then you hear from one end, somebody says, oh, well, there was a gun planted. Oh, that's all you have to hear is that somebody planted a gun on an airplane. That's, so somebody in the airline did that, or, you know, then it makes you wonder about the whole airline industry.
Every time he went to the bathroom, he was unaccompanied. He went by himself. He walked up to the bathroom, spent a few moments, came back, and repeated this three or possibly four times. And obviously, on the last time, he finds the gun.
I certainly wouldn't have let him go in there without the and close the door. I mean, to me, I think they were daydreaming or something. Maybe that's harsh, but
I figured that these men knew what they were doing. They had told me that they were federal marshals, but what I've read recently is that, in fact, they were not. They were St. Croix marshals, which makes a difference, I think. Because they might have a closer tie with him, they might have more. I'm convinced that one of them was in on it.
It only got on one of two ways. Either the guards planted it or somebody, a ground employee, planted it. I mean, I can't think of any other way, but my best guess is that the guards planted it.
I says, the one thing I need you to understand, if a guy kill 8 people, would one of us be so foolish to give him a gun and still be on the plane?